Good morning, fans of PrivateerFX. Tough day yesterday, wow. Euro yen was looking good there, up at 126.30, up at the open, but then turned around and went all the way down to 50 below. But then turned back around and here we are again, 126.11. Thankfully, we called the euro perfectly on that fade down at 112.90, 113.02 the low. Now, as you can see, at 113.80. Euro's turned briefly here, and we've just sort of marked the bottom of this new range. So you can say the top of the new range is going to be 115.10. The bottom now is 113, and we're going to do sideways in between 115.10 and 113 for a while. I do believe the risk is still on the downside, but today is not the day to be short. And if you haven't done anything, if you did not buy down at 113, you don't really want to be playing at 113.83. Not much to do here in euro, except if you have your longs. I think we're probably going to see sort of 114.10 today, and the range is going to be 113.50, 114.10 going forward. Sterling, same kind of a deal, not as strong of a turn bar as the euro. Have a look at the turn bar in euro. It's a gravestone doji, I guess they would call it in the books. Very powerful turn bar. This not as powerful, but quite a few down days here. We're due for some sort of upside knee jerk. We're gonna try and get long cable actually through 35, just as a little tactical trade. Let's see if we have any UK data today. Retail sales out of the UK today. So that'll make things a little bit more tricky. We don't really see retail sales as a big mover or a permanent mover of cable, but it does create some idiotic volatility. So careful, 10:30 Swiss time. But we're core long sterling and kind of just looks as though we're gonna make new highs today. I don't think it's gonna go running away or anything, but there's some money to be made long sterling today. Dollar yen traded down to 110.50. Now we're back at 80. Equities got crushed, but now we're a little bit higher. Don't expect to make a new high today in the S&Ps. Nazi core short all the way down to 73.17, but here we are, 74.04. Tough going on the short side. This is probably more of a tradable position than a directional position, but we'll see going forward. What else is there? Dollar Swiss. Man, we got close to that entry, 83 the high yesterday, 82.5 the high. This now is what you would call a five-star level, 99.85. When it does break, we expect serious follow-through up to the 100.70, and then eventually a revisit of these 103.40 highs. That was the end of the year last year. Aussie CAD Kiwi. Aussie also printed a pretty serious turn bar yesterday. Same kind of trade as euro. The low now is of this range. New range is 72 the figure. The high is going to be sort of 74. And we're going to trade in this range next couple of sessions. Not a whole lot to do there. Dollar Turkey traded and closed 590 yesterday. Everyone saw the headlines. Qatar is putting in 15 yards. This solves nothing. 15 yards doesn't solve anything. for the Turkish situation. The problem there is, you know, the management of this country just got their head up their ass. They really don't know what they're doing. So as hard as it is to short dollar Turkey, and of course you don't really want to be short overnight anymore now they've changed the rules on swaps. Intraday we're buying low ones. So we have our eye on this sort of 560 level today. We don't often trade dollar Turkey, and I'm not really recommending it, but we do think there's going to be support in this sort of 550, 560 area. Finally, Tesla. We talked about this, the short Tesla trade, which is paid. Just super small positions here, kind of just rooting interest. Mr. Musk is heading over to the SEC, get his wrist slapped, and he deserves it. It's not going to be the end of the world for him, but it goes back to the same old thing. Keep your head down, be below the radar, under promise, over deliver, all things this guy needs to learn, and until he does, I worry for Tesla, even though I pray that Tesla works and electric cars are the future. He's breaking cardinal rules of finance, this fella. Anyway, that's it for now. Good luck. Course short, stock still, and today as a trade, we're going to be long Sterling. Good luck out there, people.